Joker, you really thought this was a better... Well, no, it is. It is. If I would have been booking TNA, no, it wouldn't have been a better job to go here than Main Event Mafia. But not that you were going, because I don't think you really were going. I think that there was a big split between Booker and Dixie Carter. I don't think that was ever going to get fixed. But going back to this, oh boy. Booker's definitely an acquired taste.
You really think so, huh?
Yeah.
What's the main problem? Do you think he's just not...
First of all, I still think he has some to give in the ring. I'd love to see Booker T and R-Truth as the new Harlem Heat. That's just my personal thing.
You know, I don't think Booker T can just do it as much. Booker T and Sting...
Can somebody... By the way, before I say something else.
Yeah.
Can somebody look at R-Truth and look who's jobbing like crazy lately? Because somebody, again, him and Sheamus must have pissed the same person.
Our truth.
Can somebody look at the truth and John Morrison, and if you put him as a tag team, call the Incredibles? Because what they do in the ring is really incredible.
The Incredibles, that's old school.
What they do in the ring is really incredible. But going back to Booker, look, it's still too early. It's still too early, too fresh.
Okay.
I personally am not impressed, but then again, I've never thought Booker was a good talker to start with.
Really?
So, no.
I love the King Booker role. Absolutely.
Oh, King? No.
I mean, come on.
Okay, I digress. Booker goes Shakespearean. He's actually rather entertaining. When he was in the Main Event Mafia, going, respect. He was entertaining, okay?
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Okay, King Booker was incredibly entertaining.
Thank you.
Okay.
I think the man can talk.
It has a lot to do with his mannerisms.
Okay.
Not with his talking. It had a lot to do with his mannerisms. He really took on the King Booker role, and it had a lot to do with Charmel.
I didn't even
know that. God bless you at your home. You're awesome.
She is awesome.
She made him a heel. She sold him as a heel. And by the way, before we even go any further, if you ever come back to wrestling, Bobby Lashley, bring your wife with you. She is fantastic heat. Now, going back to this. Seriously, just don't let Kevin Sullivan book a divorce.
Oh!
Kevin booked his own divorce, okay? But going back to this, and we know how that ended up for everybody. Okay, so
keep going.
And I love Chris Biddle, okay? But we know how that ended up. Now, going back to this, okay? I've never been that incredibly impressed with this talking. And so, but then again, like I said before, I gotta be honest with you, in WWE announcing, period. These guys in there right now, wow. You know, I mean, seriously, wow. This company, let me get this straight. Joey Styles is working on WWE.com?
Yes.
What the hell? Who did he piss off? The same guy who pissed off Sheamus?
I guess.
What the hell? Joey Styles.
Joey Styles. Oh, my God.
Oh, my Lord, is at WWE.com, while little, who's this little guy who does SmackDown? This little, I forgot what name is. I'm like,
you're talking about Matt Stryker, right? Matt Stryker needs to be on Raw. We said
here
first.
Can we please, okay? Matt Stryker could actually...
Let's talk about Matt Stryker now.
Matt Stryker could actually become the babyface voice of WWE if you make him.
What I like about Matt Stryker is this.
He knows wrestling. He knows how to announce wrestling.
He is damn good. Sometimes he can talk a little too much, but he's learned to curtail that.
Right.
Here's what I love about Matt Stryker, okay? He actually studies and does his homework, unlike you, Jerry Lawler, who rather spends his time at shopping malls looking for the next Stacy fucking Carter.
Or the next 14-year-old.
Oh, my God, and she's following me on Twitter.
Thank you.
Whoever's following Kay Watts Covington on Twitter. Just want to make sure people know that.
Twitter.
But you know what?
That's an oxymoron I've ever heard one. Twitter.
You know what? The serious thing about it is I think Stryker has a great potential to be a really good announcer. I think, you know what it is, WWE, to be honest with you, Vince? You know what it is? You got too many new faces.
I don't think so. I love the new faces. Love the fact that last year...
I think they got too many new faces announcing.
Okay,
You got too many new faces. You need new faces on a book well in the ring.
Well, do you think Jerry? Do you think the faces? King should still be announcing? No, I think King at this point is kind of watered down.
Then the King's announcing career went to its highlight when he said puppies,
and that was in circa 1999. 12 years later.
I mean, should he be still out there? I don't know.
No.
I do know this much. Jerry Lawler was an outstanding Robin for JR's Batman. Okay,
in the WWF days.
Okay, JR was by far the best announcer of his generation. He's, before him was Gordon Solie. Announcer of his generation. The Dean. Of professional wrestling.
At the Sportatorium in his Golden Sully.
Yes, indeed.
Live.
Indeed. He's finishing the 40, indeed.
Hey, so that's how I roll.
But for today's generation, I think when JR left, seriously, Jerry Lawler shouldn't have stayed. I think Jerry Lawler was great with JR.
Yeah.
Just like Jesse the Body Ventura was fantastic with Gorilla Monsoon.
He really
was Gorilla! Gorilla! Okay, he was fantastic with Gorilla Monsoon.
What about Lord Alfred Hayes? I love that guy.
Right, and he was fantastic with Vince McMahon. Vince was the announcer, and Vince was more quality announcer himself. Right.
Him and a good work together. They really did.
So I thought that Jerry Lawler was really, really, really married to the hip with JR. And I thought when JR left, I think they should have done a whole new team. Joey Styles should have been as a lead announcer, and you should have brought in a brand new face. I don't dislike Michael Cole. I think he's done a fantastic heel announcing job. I think Michael Cole goes down with the Jesse Venturas and the great heel announcers of WWE.
Wow. That's saying something.
I think
that's for all you coal haters out there.
All you coal miners.
Yeah,
Michael Cole has the potential to be that Jesse Ventura character. Right now, there are people in WWE Universe Land.
Okay.
That want to see Michael Cole get his ass handed to him more than they want to see The Miz get his ass handed to him. That's a job that Michael Cole has done.
True.
Michael Cole, you can't hit me because you'll be fired. Oh, Michael, keep saying that because people just want to see you get hit more and more and more.
That's why he's doing a good job in his role.
Fabulous job in his role. Alberto Del Rio is never wrong. And by the way, side note, gosh, Vince, you do love Mexican wrestlers.
Let's get into this. Let's just switch gears. Okay, you are a Lucha Libre expert, you've been that way for the last, 10, 20 years. Now, of course, we all know Rey Mysterio is going to be leaving.
Mystico's coming.
Mysterio has announced, in fact, this is on WrestlingRevolution.com earlier today, a little exclusive information. Oh. He is not re-signing his new contract. Rey Mysterio is done in about 6 months.
He should be done.
Then we can book him and make some money.
There you go.
And let me
Rey Mysterio coming to a high school gymnasium near here.
Let me say this to you.
For $10.
Rey, let me say this. Because I just heard this right now. Breaking news, I just heard this right now.
It's true.
Let me say this to you. Ray, that's the smartest move we've ever done. And I want to tell you why, Ray.
It's breaking. I was almost 40
years old. And I want to say this to everybody out there. I want to say this to the Edges. I'm going to say this to everybody out there. It is best for professional wrestling to have 2 or 3 top companies. Because then the boys make more money.
True.
With that said, there is nothing that Rey Mysterio has not accomplished in WWE.
He's
accomplished everything multiple times.
In that chamber match he had at the end with Edge was really well done, by the way.
Rey Mysterio, AJ Styles match would be huge.
It would.
You know what we're talking about.
You know.
It is time for some of these guys who have nothing else to accomplish, who have done everything they can in WWE, to pass on. Let the new guys take over that company and go help build another company. And this is just my personal thing. Ray, fantastic choice because Mystico's coming in. And to be honest, Ray, no disrespect to you, Ray. No disrespect to you.
His time is gone. Come and gone.
Místico is Rey Mysterio 2.0. Ooh. He is like the next generation.
He would know.
3.0.
Okay.
He wouldn't know, but he would know.
He's the next generation of what you started, my friend. You started this, okay? Nobody could have ever thought that they were going to give a 185-pound man the WWE World Heavyweight title.
He's got 185. Rey Mysterio's 165, yeah. Soaking wet.
Well, he's 185 with the roids.
Thank you for agreeing with me on that.
But no, seriously speaking, for that, okay? And let's be honest, the McMahon family has always had love.
For the big guys.
For Spanish, but also for Spanish
wrestling. True.
This goes back to, I'm going to go real old school now for about 20 seconds. This goes back to Vince's father with Argentina Roca and Miguel Perez.
Ooh, okay. Miguel Perez. I remember that name. That name I've heard before.
Argentina Roca from Argentina. The reason my grandmother bought a black and white TV to see him.
Damn.
Okay? Later on, Pedro
Morales. My grandmother bought a black and white TV to see Freddie Blassie. Just let you know. Yeah. Yeah, just go ahead. Yeah.
We're in the same way.
True story.
Dan?
CJ bought a black and white TV because he can't afford anything else.
Nah, stop it. And so now, yeah, stop.
Have a job.
Stop.
Keep going.
Now, next. Pedro Morales. Go to Tito Santana. Then go to Eddie Guerrero. Go to how you are. Vince, I want to say this to you right now. Thank you so much. You have kept the Guerrero family employed. And after all the stuff that has happened in your company, and Vince is behind, a lot of deaths behind you, brother. Bottom line is, you've kept them employed. And what you've done for Eddie Guerrero, what you've done with Chavo, having his
employed. Yeah, Vicky's still in the company.
Vicky is employed and on fire. She's on fire. Excuse me, Vicky! You are on fire.
She
God bless you. You're a trooper. God bless you. And now Rey Mysterio, and now Dos Caras Jr. That's who Alberto Del Rio is, Dos Caras Jr.
Yes.
By the way, he's the nephew of another legend that wrestled for WWE for Vince's father, Mil Máscaras. Okay, that's
Mil
who you're
Máscaras.
Watching. You're watching the nephew of the most well-renowned international Mexican wrestler.
And you know what I love about the fact about Alberto Del Rio?
And now Místico comes in. So.
Now, well, about the fact that... Shut your mouth. What I love about the fact about Alberto Del Rio's heel characters is actually being built as a strong character.
Yes.
He's actually getting over by beating wrestlers clean.
He is.
And
beating
not the chicken
clean.
Shit baby face
no.
that you see out of the Miz.
Alberto Del Rio
okay?
is going to become a massive baby.
He is
face
winning at WrestleMania.
A year and a half. Yeah, he's winning at WrestleMania. There's
okay?
no question about it. By the way, Alberto, your announcer is awesome.
Your announcer sucks.
No, he's awesome. Now, going back to this, Alberto Del Rio he's going to become
we
about,
love
in about a year, a year and a half. Alberto Del Rio is going to become a massive baby face.
I believe
it really is, and I'll tell you why. Because Alberto Del
Rio. Oh, what's going on here?
What is this?
What is this?
Oh, yeah, here, people, we have a problem.
Oh my
Houston,
God,
Houston,
we have a problem.
Houston, we have a problem.
So, who is that guy?
I have no clue what he's talking about.
Does he wrestle at FCW?
Who
is that guy? I have no idea.
Wait,
thank you.